Previously on Eric Strebel's Design and Making Channel.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
If you haven't seen the Acrylics Basics video, make sure you check that out before you watch this video. Link in the top right and in the description below. Here's a recap of the basic tools that I like to use for working with acrylic.
Some sort of acrylic scoring cutting tool, acrylic solvent, and some sort of dispenser like this Lure Lock bottle with a little blunt nose needle. 30 gauge works fantastic. A sipper bit, a good steel ruler, and maybe a file and some sandpaper. This video assumes that you don't have access to a laser cutter. We're going to use heat to bend this cube and have radiused corners. And for that, we're going to use a heat bender. This is my 12-inch water-cooled heat bender. Amazon link in the description below. We're cycling water through an aquarium. It comes with a digital thermometer so you can keep tabs on the water temperature. This unit has a variable temperature control and allows you to regulate the temperature of the heating element inside of the unit. Let's cut a piece of acrylic to the right length for our radius corner heat bent cube. To determine the piece of acrylic's correct length, you need to determine the inside size of the cube you're building. We know that the outside is 50.8 millimeters square. Because we know the material's thickness of 3 millimeters, we can calculate the inside of this cube. It's about 180 millimeters, and so that's how long our strip is. I'm gonna mark off the radius points on the piece of acrylic and then set the acrylic onto our heat bender. I'm gonna flip it over so that I can heat both sides of the acrylic and get a nice bend. I'm going to place this into a pre-made jig, and this pre-made jig has two walls spaced 50.8 millimeters apart from each other. This allows us to build the cube correct and square. Let's move on to the next bend. We're going to soften that up, and then we'll place that back into the jig to make our second corner. We're letting the jig do all the work. I use a clamp to hold the acrylic in place while it cools down. The jig is merely made from 3/4 inch MDF scrap material. Let's go on to the next corner. Again, heating the acrylic on both sides is the way I like to do it. We're gonna place it back into the jig and bend the third corner. The fourth corner is the trickiest because you can only heat the acrylic on one side, so you need to be careful here. With the pre-calculated strip calculated correct, the cube folds into a nice box and you get something like this with the seam on the back side in the middle. We're going to use a basic flood joint and we're going to connect that seam together with an additional piece of scrap acrylic. I'm going to clamp that in place while it dries. This is going to give us a nice tight bond. Any overflow can be polished out later. Let's sand the cube flat and blow it off with a little bit of air. Now let's build the end caps for the cube. I'm just gonna rough cut these end caps on the bandsaw and then glue them onto the flattened ends of the cube because ultimately we're gonna flush cut these things to the correct size of the cube. Add a little weight, let it cure. Now let's hook up the flush cut bit on the router and trim the top and the bottom. During the flush cut process, the bearing actually starts to mar the acrylic This is unfortunate on my end, but that's how it goes. Obviously, this is not something you want, so you need to make sure that the bearing is lubricated properly and is of good quality. It's something that I'm going to have to clean up after. To do this, I'm going to use my acrylic polishing pad on my drill press with a little bit of acrylic polishing compound. I'm able to polish out most of the marks, but not all of them. We're going to deal with that in the next video called Finishing Your Acrylic. This is my De'Longhi convection toaster oven. Its sole purpose is to heat shit up. In this case, we're gonna heat up a piece of acrylic and try to drape form it. I'm using a piece of extruded acrylic. It has a slightly lower melting temperature than cast acrylic, and I find it makes it ideal for drape forming. I slowly increase the temperature from 250 to 300 over approximately 2 hours to get a nice curved piece of plastic. Let it cool, and this is what you get.
So that's our part. Pretty nice.
Now that all the parts are cut for the rest of the cube, I'm gonna solvent weld it all together with dichloromethane. You can learn more about that from the previous video, Acrylic Basics, if you haven't seen that already. You should wear the proper organic vapor mask and safety gear when you're using dichloromethane, as it's not particularly good when you inhale it or get it on your skin. Here, I'm using a little bit of thickened acrylic cement to fill in some of the gaps, and I'm using a brush to apply it. I don't generally use that, but I want to show it in the video as one of the solvent options, and then I usually go back and add a little bit of the liquid on the backside just to help adhere everything together, even with the thickened cement. So next, I'm just sanding the piece of drape-formed clear acrylic that we made previously so that it fits inside the two sides of the cube, and we'll cut this off so that we can adhere it to the cube that we just built. I'll use a little bit of thickened cement on the backside where I know that I don't have real good surface, and I'll use the thin solvent on the front. I'll even come back and add a little bit of the thin stuff to keep the thickened cement soft as we glue it all together. Then I'll use a little bit of the thin cement on the side to glue the last edges. Let's replace that crappy bearing on the flush trim bit with a brand new one and trim against the drape-formed clear curved part that we made earlier. Let's polish out any marks that are in the part and then use a little bit of lacquer thinner to clean up any marks from fabrication and polishing compound. Now that we have the next cube built, let's press form mold some acrylic. To do this, we'll heat up a piece of cast acrylic in the DeLonghi toaster oven. Once it's been heated, the material will be soft, flexible, and almost rubber-like. The nice thing about press form molding is that it takes less heat and less time than drape forming. I place the soft acrylic part in between the wooden form. It's a male and a female, and I press it together, and this gives us our part quite quickly. Next, I trim the part on the bandsaw so that it's square and the correct dimensions so that we can place it on top of our cube. Lastly, I will solvent weld the press form molded part onto the top of the black cube to finish it. You can brush a little bit of dichloral methane onto the rough saw cut acrylic parts. This will smooth them out a little bit and give you a little bit of a nicer finish on your parts if you forget to sand them like I did. You can sand the edges of your rough saw cut acrylic, and then you can apply some heat to it so that you can flame polish and smooth out those acrylic edges without having to polish them. We'll take a little bit of heat from a torch and we'll make a few passes along that edge that will slightly melt the plastic and give you a nice finished edge on your acrylic. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.